Scientists just can't seem to get enough glass. Despite the material being about as common as can be, some are still poking and prodding it, trying to unravel its mysteries. And now, one group of scientists experimenting with this material has stumbled onto a state of matter that was predicted 20 years ago. Liquid glass. Now, some of you are gonna jump up right away and assert that glass is already a liquid. Well, I hate to shatter your world, but it turns out that's just one of those myths that won't go away. Glass is not a very slow-moving liquid, as some like to claim, unless we're talking about cosmic timescales. But it is an unusual solid. While other solids tend to line up in neat, orderly crystal patterns, glass plays by different rules. Its structure is random and unpredictable, so it's known as an amorphous solid. While we tend to think of the silica-based material used for windows and phone screens as glass, any rigid amorphous solid can be one. Plastic, for example, is a glass too. Why glass forms this way, why it doesn't line up into neat rows except under theoretically impossible conditions, that is the mystery that keeps drawing scientists back to this material. And that's why one group based out of Germany decided to try something new. They mixed plastic particles that ranged from 1 to 10 micrometers in diameter with a solvent to form what's called a colloid. A solvent is just a substance in which materials can dissolve to form a solution, and colloids can be anything from jam to milk. Colloids can form glass and are easy to study because the particles in them are much bigger than atomic scale, so they can be observed under a microscope. From there, scientists can draw conclusions about what's happening in other materials at smaller scales. Glass experiments with colloids are hardly new, but until now they had always been done with spherical nanoparticles. But for their experiment, these scientists decided to use ellipsoidal particles, which, unlike spherical ones, have a clear orientation. Because of their shape, it's easier to tell when they rotate versus when they translate or move back and forth and side to side. The researchers said they chose non-spherical plastic nanoparticles because they're more like the asymmetrical particles actually found in nature. It wasn't until recently, though, that scientists even had the ability to make these materials. When the researchers suspended a certain density of these ellipsoidal particles in a solvent, they formed a glass. They created rigid structures and they couldn't rotate. But they could still translate back and forth, so the particles could be said to be in a liquid state. Researchers had accidentally created a new phase of matter. Astonished by their findings, they dug through the literature on the subject and actually found a 20-year-old paper that predicted such a thing might happen. Now, there were some things the paper didn't predict, though, like how similarly oriented particles would bunch up and form structures that could then intersect with other structures at random angles. The scientists suspect this behavior might explain why glass forms seemingly random shapes as it cools. But the case on glass is far from cracked. This latest discovery may reflect some hidden truths about the material, but there's plenty more research to be done. And I'm pretty sure glass will keep fascinating scientists for a long time to come. If you want to learn even more about the mysteries of glass, check out Julian's video here. And if there's another topic you want us to cover, let us know down in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.